Last week, the newspapers reported that between the time of the 16th of March and the 1st of April, Women in Need, which is an organization that supports women who are victims of abuse, had received more than 250 phone calls, 60% of which were about or in relation to domestic violence. Domestic violence is a very real problem. And this is something that is getting spoken of more now that we are here in our homes. And it is also a time that we are told that women, and all of us, are safest at this point in time in our homes. But in reality, for many women, that is not the case. And we're talking about domestic violence, but there's also workplace harassment, street harassment, sexual harassment. There are many kinds of abuse and harassment. These are very real problems, and these are problems that the state definitely has the onus in trying to resolve, in trying to fix through laws and through implementing the laws correctly. But at this point in time, we also want to discuss how then do we make a difference? What can we do to make it right? Or what can we do to help someone through? And the answers that I'd like to give you is that there are no simple answers. There's nothing simple and easy about it. It's quite complicated. But it starts with acknowledging the violence, because through our silence and through our silent suffering, sometimes we aren't able to move past it. So for somebody who may be experiencing violence, maybe you need to talk to somebody in your own homes, maybe somebody outside your home, someone you can trust, maybe somebody in your workplace, if it's workplace harassment, reaching out to somebody else. Sometimes it's a little more complicated than that. You have to reach out to another person, maybe an organization that has the ability to financially, emotionally, and physically support you get past it. Sometimes it may mean having to talk to law enforcement, going to the police, maybe seeking out a lawyer. So these things are definitely complicated. And the emotions of fear, guilt, shame, anger and resentment are all there and all present. In those spaces. So what is it that we can do? We can do all of that. That is a possibility. We can also find ways that if we are in a space where we're confronted with violence, to not be, or somebody else is confronted with violence, to not be a bystander and to not be silent and to find ways to support that person. And this needs for us to be conscious and mindful and above all, brave, which is easier said than done, but it is what is needed so that others don't also suffer in silence.